السلام عليكم، أنا تدريسية مي أبو جلود، أستاذة مادة النحو في قسم الترجمة المرحلة الثانية الدراستين الصباحية والمسائية. Today I'm going to give an introductory lecture about grammar, second year translation departments. We deal with one main resource book, which is entitled Communicate What You Mean by Carla Bullock. This important reference grammar is different from other references, considering the fact that it teaches students not only how to apply the rules of grammar, but how to deal with different situations of life in general. So this book teaches students not how to communicate correctly, not how to deal with language in a perfect grammatical correct way, but how to deal with different situations and circumstances in life. Because as we all know, that life and language have something in common, which is the fact that everything changes. That's why language grows. That's why language develops. That's why we need to be flexible to know how to deal with the rules of grammar correctly. The book deals with 8 chapters, 8 important topics, starting with tenses, variety of tenses. We have future tense, we have present tense, past tense, and it's very interesting about future time, actually, which is, I believe, is a very new subject, new area students need to tackle, is the fact that we are dealing with future perfect and future perfect continuous. These are very important topics, and maybe the students are not quite familiar with it. That's why we need to focus and shed light on it. The second chapter deals with coordinations. We have conjunctions, types of conjunctions. We have 3 types of conjunctions: adverb, correlative, conjunctions, and we have adjective clauses, adverb clauses. We deal with passive voice, active voice. Maybe students are quite familiar with most of the topics, but sometimes I need to elaborate more information for them. Maybe they need to refresh their information, to strengthen their information background. That's why when I deal with coordinations, for example, I have to talk about clauses. I have to differentiate between dependent and independent clauses. This is very important for the students to refresh his or her memory and his or her information. Of course, I have to cover 80% or maybe 90% of the book. I have 8 chapters to deal, to cover, and I tend to examine my students. I have 2 monthly exams or 2 course exams, each course. And of course, the everyday participation should pay off the students, and I have to add marks for students when he or she is more active in comparison with other students. Sometimes I need to use other reference books like Comprehensive Grammar of English or Everyday English in order to enrich the students with more information. After shedding light on the information, I need to go through the practice exams and to go through the most important exercises in order in this way students can apply the information they got and make them into more answers and key answers of the book, of course. Sometimes I need to check the internet to give them more information and to give them more practice, because practice makes perfect, as we all know, and language is a matter of it's a matter of practice, so they need to shed light on the practical side of language. This is very important in addition to the information, because grammar is not only how to apply, how to memorize rules, it's a matter how to apply them, how to choose the right rule. Of course, there are many challenges. Dealing with students is not easy. It's a tough mission, and especially grammar, because grammar is not a very enjoyable lesson, to be frank. Some students find it a very difficult subject, but it is the backbone of language. A student should acquire rules, and especially in our department, translation department, they need to differentiate between the tenses, sequence of tenses, and to know how to connect words and ideas and sentences, because this is what translation is all about, how to connect ideas, how to express in a good way. So usually in these 2 courses, I deal with the chapters. I give them information, informations of the book, and then we deal with the answers. And then we, sometimes I have to resort to make not only monthly exams but quizzes, because it's very important to sharpen their memory and to update them with the most important information they need. So this is my introductory lesson. I hope it's enjoyable and rich, and I hope we can meet soon. Thank you so much.